Let us look at what is inside an exchange. Look at this block diagram and also the roles of each of these blocks very clearly mentioned. The figure is highly detailed and self-explanatory. This will give you a pretty good idea of how the entire switching action takes place in a PSTN. Continue to peep inside the exchange in this slide also. The block diagram and the role play of each of these blocks is very clearly brought out in this figure, and the figure is self-explanatory. Let's try and answer some questions. What are the maintenance functions of a switching system? Supervision of subscriber lines and trunk circuits constitutes the major maintenance function of a switching system. What are the operational functions of a switching system? There are two parts, administrative and statistical. Administrative data such as subscriber database, routing database. Statistical data such as from where and whom the subscribers call, holding times for different equipment types, utilization of intelligent network services, etc. could be part of the operational functions. What are the typical IN services? Look at the table that's appearing on your screen, which contains an exhaustive list of all kinds of intelligent network services. What are the typical exchange user services? There are several of them. Just to name a few, absent subscriber services, call booking, person-to-person call, serial call, telephone conferencing, directory inquiries, call-related CLID, call waiting. These could be some of the typical exchange user services. I want to make a call to my grandmother. Let us try and trace a complete PSTN call flow. Look at the figure which is animated. This is a typical call flow sequence in a PSTN scenario. In this example, a call is made by me connected to exchange, which is called switch 1 at one location, to my grandma connected to another exchange and at a different location, maybe 10 kilometers away. The signaling activities, please recall from previous subchapter, for this call are through CCS and is being handled by SS7 network. We will see SS7 in detail as we go on. What are the call flow sequences? Action 1, I pick up the phone and send an off-hook indication to the end office switch. The switch sends back a dial tone. I dial the digits to call grandma's house. They are sent in-band through DTMF. Next, the switch interprets the digits and sends an initial address message, IAM, or setup message to the SS7 network. The SS7 network reads the incoming IAM and sends a new IAM to grandma switch. Grandma switch sends up a setup message to grandma's phone. It rings her phone. An alerting message is sent from grandma switch back to the SS7 network through an address complete message called ACM. The SS7 network reads the incoming ACM and generates an ACM to my switch. The ninth sequence is I can hear a ringing sound and know that grandma's phone is ringing. Please note, the ringing is not synchronized. Your local switch normally generates a ringing when the ACM is received from the SS7 network. Please note, that this is called a ringback tone. The ringback tone is not generated by the far end or the grandma switch, but it is your local switch which generates this ringing when the ACM is received from the SS7 network. 10th action, grandma picks up her phone, sending an off-hook indication to a switch. Grandma switch sends an answer message ANM that is read by the SS7 and a new ANM is generated to my switch. A connect message is sent to my phone only if it is an ISDN phone, and a connect acknowledgement is sent back again only if it is an ISDN phone. If it is not an ISDN phone, then on-hook or off-hook representations signal the end of his switch. 13th action, I can now talk to grandma until I hang up the phone, that is on-hook indication. After the conversation is over, as the 14th action, let us say I disconnect. On-hook is sensed as a disconnect by my exchange. My switch sends a release message to SS7 network and from the SS7 network to my grandma switch to release all the circuits. 16. Grandma gets a busy tone indicating that I have disconnected through a disconnect message. Then grandma disconnects and this is sensed as release on-hook message by grandma switch. 18th action, grandma switch sends a release complete message to SS7 network and from SS7 network back to my switch. The loop connection at my end is released. Now the entire set of connections or the entire set of circuits end to end are released for the next set of users. This completes a typical PSTN call flow. What is the principle behind it? This is called circuit switching. That is, the route is maintained for the entire duration of the call. Route setup is, by now you would have understood, an expensive operation just as it was for manual switching. But fortunately today, complex least cost routing algorithms are used. Call duration consists of setup, voice and teardown phases. Billing is for the voice duration only and normally billed to the calling subscriber.